Hello, my dear friends. So the question we are going to solve today is like this. A array is given to us. So what is our task? Our task is to sort the arrays in which only 0, 1, 2 and 0, 1 and 2 are given. Okay. So array will be like this, which will consist of 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. Okay. So finally, what we have to do? We have to sort this array in which first 0 will come. Then at mid range 1 will come, then at the end 2 will come. Okay, here also you can see. So in initially we have all the zeros, then we have all the ones, then we have all the 2. Okay, so we have to put all 0 first, then all 1, then all 2 in the last. So this is our question. So first thing that click in my mind is that we can use the sorting method. Okay, we can sort this array. So once this array is sorted, so our elements will be like this 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2. Okay, after sorting, we are going to get this array. So one thing that click in my mind is we need to do the sorting. Okay, now for sorting, if we are going to use quick sort, bubble sort, insertion sort, okay, so these are going to use the time complexity of order of n square. But if we want to reduce the time, right? If we want to reduce the time, so we can use the merge sorting. So merge sort will take order of n log n, right? I am expecting that you know all the names, right? Which is bubble, insertion, merge sort, right? So if you are going to use Python, so in Python the syntax is very simple. Suppose you got an array, and if you want to sort that array, suppose this is an array contained of 0, 1, 0, 1, 2. Suppose this is an array given to us. If you want to sort this array, you are going to use array.sort this function, and just you are going to return this. If you are going to return this, what the sort function will do? It will automatically sort the array, entire array, and will give you the output 0, 0, 1, 1, 2. Okay, so this sort function in Python is going to use order of n log n. Okay, that is merge sort timing. Perfect. So in Python, this question is just of a single line that we need to use the function sort, and it is going to sort this array dot sort this. So this is the method one to solve this approach, that is a using a inbuilt function, right? Method two, let's try to focus on the second method. Okay, suppose an array is given to us 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. Okay, so here the time complexity that we have seen is order of n log n. Suppose if we want to reduce this time complexity, suppose we want just to traverse this array only once. So second approach that click in my mind is, let us make three variables, count, count 0, second variable will be count 1, and third variable will be count 2. So what I will do, I will traverse the array, and as soon as I get the 0, I will increase the count of 0. As soon as I get the value as 1, I will increase the count of 1. As soon as I get the count of 2, as soon as I get the element 2 in the array, I will increase the count of 2. So once the array traverse will complete, so how many zeros we are having here? 2 zeros. How many 1 we are having? 2, 1. And how many 2 we are having? 2, 2. So we have got the number of zeros, number of 1 and number of 2 in the array. Now what we need to do? Again we have to use a for loop. Again we have to use a for loop for I in range of length of array. Perfect. So what we will do? We will update. So 2 times we are going to update this array with 0. 2 times we are going to update. Okay, this was the question. 2 times we are going to update this array with 0. Then 2 times we are going to update with the array with 1. And 2 times we are going to update this array with the So this is the second approach that we are going to use. So first of all, we have to traverse this entire array to count the number of zeros 1 and 2. So what is the order of complexity? Order of n. As we have to traverse the entire array only once, so it will take order of n time. Now to update that array, it is again going to use order of n time, because we have to go to each element and update that element according to the counts that we have got. So if you are going to see time complexity in this, we are going to get order of 2n, which will be again order of n. This is just showing that order of n, it will be order of 2n, but it will be considered as order of n complexity only. Okay, so first of all, let us try to write this solution. Okay, counting approach solution. So I am going to write the Python syntax, right? So let us move to the solution part. Let us write a function sort array. This is a function name which will contain array and the size of array. Now let us make the three variables count 0. Initially every count is 0. Okay, count 2, this is also 0. Now what I told you, we have to traverse the for loop. So for I in range of n, and what is n here? N is length of string, length of array. Perfect. So we have to traverse this entire array, and now I am going to apply the condition. If array of I equal to 0, if we got that element is 0, so what we are going to do? We are going to update count 0 with the 1. So count 0 will be I am going to write plus equals to 1. So what does this mean? It means count 0 will be count 0 plus 1. So you can write any of the one, either this or this. Okay, both statement represent same thing. So I am going to write the first one. So count 0 plus equals to 1. Again, else if. So in else if Python, how we are writing? We are using elif. So elif element is equal to 1. So what we are going to do? We are going to increase of count 1 plus equals to 1. Let's write elif only, because if the elements are other than 1, 2, 3, then we don't have to make in the count. Elif array of I equal to 2. What we are going to do? We are going to increase the count of 2 by 1. So this is that we will traverse the entire array, and we are going to get the count of 0, 1 and 2. Okay. Now what we are going to do? We are going to again use a for loop to update the elements. So let us do one thing. Let us write I is equal to 0 again, to make the I should come at the first place. As soon as I come as the first place, I am going to use a while loop. While count 0 is greater than 0. So what I am going to do? I am going to use array of I is equal to 0. What I have done here? Suppose we have got count 0 value as 2. So 2 is greater than 0. So what it will do? It will update array of 0 with 0. Now I am going to increase the value of I. Okay. And also decrease the value of 1, this count, because we have filled one element with the count 0. So this count 0 minus equals to 1. So what it will do? It will increase the value of I. So suppose this is the value of count 0 and I value is 0 initially. So I value will become 1 and it will become 1. So 1 is also greater than 0, correct? So it will again go in the loop. It will update a array of 1 with 0. I will increase now. I will become 2 and count will become 0. So 0 is not greater than 0. So if you are going to see, 0 is not greater than 0. So this while loop will end. Again, what we are going to do? Now we are going to use while loop. As we have updated all the zeros, Now what we are going to do, we are going to update all the ones, right? So while count of 1 is greater than 0, okay, so this time we are going to update array of I with the 1, and again we are going to use I plus equals to 1 and count 1 minus equals to 1. So this will update all the elements of the array with the 1. Okay, now finally what we have to do, we have to do for the 2. So while count 2 is greater than 0, update the array with 2, increase I, so I plus equals to 1, and decrease the count of the 2. So count 2 minus equals to 1. Okay, so now our array is updated. So what we can do is, we can return the array. Okay, return array. Perfect. So this is the function that we have written. So what in this function, what we have done, if you are going to say it properly, first of all we have took the three variables count 0, count 1 and count 2. Then we have updated the count 0, count 1 and count 2, means how many zeros are there in the array, how many 1 are there in the array, how many 2s are there in the array. Then what we have done, we have used the while loop and updated all the elements of the array according to the count, and at the end we have written the array. So this is the second approach that we can use to solve. Now suppose if the interviewer say that here the time complexity is already order of n, but if you can see, it is clearly seen that we are using traversing the for loop 2 times. Try to optimize this solution more. Okay, suppose if you got this thing. So first we have seen that we can do is order of n square here. Okay, then we have got that we can do this question in order of n log n. First we have seen then n square, then n log n. Now we have optimized to order of 2n. Suppose if the interviewer say that I will allow you to traverse only once, just to test your ability to think, or just to test your ability to you can think or not. Okay, this problem is solved. Means you, order of 2n is generally considered as order of n, because we do not give importance to the constant which is present there. Okay, so suppose if he told you, try to optimize it more. So now what we are going to do, we are going to use one different approach. So method 3. Suppose an array is given to us. What is the array? 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. Now in this array, we are going to use the pointers approach. So what we are going to do, we need to sort 0, 1s and 2s. Okay, so here you have seen the binary search approach for the 0s and 1. So similar kind of approach we are going to use here. So here what we are going to do, we are going to use the three variables low, mid and high. Okay, low will start from 0, mid will also start from 0, and highest element will start from length of array minus 1. So here we are going to have low, and here we are going to have mid, here we are going to have high. Okay, we have three pointers that are indicating the position. Now with the help of mid, we are going to traverse the array. Okay, and with the help of mid, we are going to traverse the array, and first elements must be 0, then in middle we have 1, and at right side we have the elements as 2. So what approach we are going to use here is, if array of mid equal to 0, suppose if we got element as, suppose here is the mid, and suppose here we have the low. Okay, suppose here is the low, here is the mid. I am just trying to explain you the situation. If mid got the element as 0, so what it will do, it will swap the element with the lower one. It will swap the element with the lower one. So if we got mid as 0, swap array of low and array of mid. So once the swapping is done, we are going to increase the count of low as well as count of mid. So low will be equals to low plus 1, mid will be equals to mid plus 1. So after this swapping, what will be the array become like this? 0, 0, 2, 1, 1, 2. And we will have low, our low will be here. And our mid will be here, something like this. This will be the situation. Okay, so just told you the example. If the element is, if the mid got 0, at that time we are going to swap this with the lower element, because 0 should be there in the left hand side. Now if array of mid is equal to 1, so if we have got mid element as 1, suppose it is here, mid element as 1, so mid should be always kept in the middle only, 1 should be always kept in the middle only. So what we are going to do, we are just going to update the value of m, and we are not going to change swap mid with anyone, because 1 should be there in the middle only. Okay, suppose if there is a situation like this, what is the situation? That mid got the value 2, mid got the value 2. So once mid got the value 2, it should be swapped with the higher element. It should be swapped with the higher element, because 2 is always going to be present at the last. So if array of mid equals to 2, what we are going to do, we are going to swap mid and higher element, array of high, and high will be reduced by 1, h will be become h minus 1. Okay, so I will tell you working of this entire solution. Perfect. So let us start with the first step. Let us start with the example. So the concept is this: if we got 0, we will swap with the mid and low, and then low plus 1, mid plus 1. Okay, then mid plus 1, then high plus 1. Okay, so let us take the example and let us try to traverse the 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. Perfect. Now, initially, low will be at 0, mid will be also at 0, high will be also at 0. So let us enter in the loop. So first element, array of mid is equal to 0. So what I told you, swap with the lower element. So lower and mid are same. So if after swapping also situation will be same only. It means what we have to do, we have to increase low by 1 and mid by 1. As mentioned here, low will be increased and mid is also going to be increased. So what we are going to get, we are going to get low, let me close this. Yeah, so here we will get low as well as mid now. Again, now what we will see, if array of mid is 1, so what I told you, we will just increase the mid. It means mid is going to come here now. Okay, so if array of m, now we have came, if array of m is equal to 2, swap with the higher element. So this 2 will come here, this 2 will go here. Means after this step, it will be 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. You are not seeing any kind of change, because the highest element was 2. But according to our code, we have done the changes. So we have used this condition. So here h will become h minus 1. It means higher element will come here. Now again, what we have got? We have got array of m is again at 2. So I told you, if m is again at 2, it means we are going to use this condition. In this condition, we have to swap middle term and higher term. So again, swap the terms. So 1 will come here and 2 will go here. So after swapping, it will be 0, 1, 1, 0, 2, 2. Okay, this will be the situation. Lower will be same. I told you, higher will be decreased by 1 if we are using this condition. Middle is also same, and higher will be decreased by 1. So it was indicating this position, now it will indicate this position. Okay, now we got mid as 1. So again, using the condition of mid as 1, this was the condition for mid as 1. So what we are going to do, we are just going to increase the position of the mid. So we have reached here. Now we have got mid as 0. So what was the condition that we have written for the mid as 0? The condition was swap array of left and array of mid. It means we need to swap which element? Array of this and this are going to be swapped now. It means 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2. And this time low and mid both are going to increase. So low was here, it will come low here. High was here, mid is also going to be increased. So mid will come here. So as soon as mid cross the high, it means array is sorted now. So you can check the results also. We have sorted the array. Okay, so this was the code, and I also shown you how it will function. Okay, so let us write the final code now. So working I also told you, I tell you the example also. So let us write the function define sort 012, which will take a n size of array n. Array n size of array. We will make three variables. Low will be at 0, high will be at length of n minus 1, and mid will be at again 0. I told you we are going to start with the 0. Now I told you while mid is less than equals to, mid is less than equals to high, what we are going to do? We are going to check now if array of mid equal to equal to 0. First of all, we will check for 0. So what we are going to do, we are going to swap the array of low and array of mid with the array of mid and array of low. Array of mid and array of low. Perfect. So this is the thing that we are going to do, okay, for the swapping. Correct. You can write the sort swap function also. Okay, you can do swapping in many things. I am expecting you know how to swap the elements. So what it will do, it will update array of low with the array of middle, and it will update array of middle with the array of low. Right, once the swapping is done, I told you we are going to increase low by 1 and mid also by 1 in the case of 0. This is done. Now let us write the code for the if array of mid equals to equals to 1. So I told you if we are in the mid, we will not do anything, we will just move, because 1 should be there in the middle only. This is done, right? So it will be else if, and else finally what we will do, if the element is not 0 and 1, expecting the element is 0 only. So you can use else also. And if you want elif, then you need to write the condition. Else, what we told, we will swap the mid element. Okay, we have array of mid, array of high. It should be swapped with array of high, comma, array of mid. Right, it is going to be swapped like this. Once we have done the swapping, high will be reduced by 1. Okay, so once this while loop completes, what we will do, we will return our array. Return array. Perfect. So this is the third approach that we have seen. So I hope you got some idea how different types of approaches we can use. So first of all, we have seen basic sync things, then we have gone to one different kind of approach, then we have gone to some other kind of approach. Okay, so if you still have any kind of confusion, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you.